All right, hey, we're back in the shop, and we've got the entire model riveted. It's looking great. Now it's time to dirty it up and make it look like it's been doing a little war duty for the last 6 or 8 months on the main line. First thing we need to do is to sit down and basically come through and chip some of our paint on the aircraft. So as we look at the leading edge of like the cowlings, the wings, the tail, etc., you're going to find the paint gets chipped as the aircraft fly through the air at 200, 300, 400 miles an hour, especially like P-47 doing a lot of ground pounding exercises, rockets, bombs on targets, blowing up trains, the shrapnel from that, the explosions. It just tends to pit and make the leading edges just chip all the paint away. Now, in this aircraft being all aluminum, we sit down and the only place we have paint on the leading edge of the wings is the yellow stripe, and as well as on the vertical and the yellow stripe there. So we've gone ahead and I've already touched those. We'll show them to you here in a second. And you will find that the leading edge of the wings has more paint missing than the leading edge of the vertical. It's further back, stuff's gone through. But we're going to show you how to do that. Very simple and easy to do here on the cowling. I start with my Model Master paint and aluminum. I shake it up real well. And I just have a standard brush, a small little paint brush. And you notice a paper towel. This is a big part. As I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get my paintbrush set with some paint, and now I'm going to come back and I'm going to dry brush a fair amount of the paint off. Now, all we do is we dab it. And you do this around the entire perimeter of the cowling. So as you can see, we've gone ahead and definitely chipped a fend, taken off a lot of paint here in the leading edge. Now, what we're going to do is, you can see what I've done on the olive drab is kind of like the flak burst. And you just do some of these around, and then I will rub with my finger. And a little bit more. So that pretty much shows you how to chip the paint up on the airplane. Another feature I did on the cowling on this airplane, as you can see, is I actually cut the cowl feathers that on the real airplane open and close for engine cooling. I just cut the slit, and that was it, because we have, of course, the mounting tabs here to mount the cowl. I didn't want to really break stuff loose a lot, but cut them up. The cowling's still going to be plenty secure. I cut them across the top. There's no panel line on the top for this, so I just kind of measured out and cut, because the cowl flaps went all the way around the cowling on the top, just definitely to add another aspect of scale to the airplane. So our cowling is done and ready to be weathered with some dirt. So what we're going to do is talk a little bit about the rest of the airplane. I've done that same type of technique on the fuselage here. We can kind of take a look on the wing. You can see the leading edge. We've got it, and we want to finish up with a little bit of paint chippage on the yellow. Just trying to bring the model to life a little bit. Now, a big part of the P-47 are the four guns that reside in the leading edge of the wing. And keep in mind, these had to be loaded and maintained a lot every flight. So on the top of the wing was the main panel. Let's see if I can find it, which is right here. This panel hinged on the back and opened up, so that it would stand up vertically as they loaded all the ammunition, the nine yard long ammo belts and such. So we're going to go ahead and chip the paint right around the leading edge and the side here, as that would have seen a lot of usage. And I'm going to come down and I'm going right down the panel line. And all I'm doing is kind of painting over the yellow, and I'm trying to paint in a jagged motion to show kind of chips of paint. Going to sit down and get the leading edge here where the black and the yellow is. Here you can see how we've kind of chipped the paint on the leading edge and the side. Remember, it's hinged on the back, so not much paint removed back here. But up here is the guys would grab onto the panel, open and close it, drop it down. Things may get laid on it and such over time. You can see the paint chippage around that area. We'll do that to the other wing as well. Okay, so here we're on the left wing, and as you can see with a star and bar, we also have to kind of scratch the paint on the leading edge of our gun panel, access panel for ammo, on the sides through the star and bar, and then also through the yellow and black, hinged on the back and rolls up. You notice I'm not chipping the paint, I guess as you would say, here on the leading edge where it's silver, and that's because the real airplane was bare aluminum. They didn't take time to paint the airplanes silver. Mustangs, P-47s, B-17s in the day took a lot of time, and they're trying to push airplanes out for the war effort. So they were just bare aluminum, painted on markings, and that was it. So that's where we're going through and chipping the paint everywhere around there. All right, so now that we pretty much have all of our paint chipped, and you do that across the airplane wherever you see fit and whatever you want to do, the next thing we need to do is now we need to start streaking the airplane and making it look a little dirty and weathered. All right, on the bottom side of the right wing, we have a couple things. One, you'll notice a red, a green, and then an amber colored dot here on near the wingtip. These were formation lights on the P-47, and they were there on every P-47 in this location, only under the right wing. So the red is done with a red Sharpie, the green is done by a green Sharpie, and the yellow is done with Tester's Insignia yellow paint. And it's just painted on there and let dry to give you that effect. Here, you find four black rectangles, and they are in line with the guns almost. These are the shell ejector ports on the real aircraft. They would have been holes, and this is where the brass was ejected as the guns fired and stuff. I didn't want to put big holes in there and such, but so I've just kind of given that illusion of how that is. So this is done with a black Sharpie as well. So now, as you can see, little differences on the bottom of the right wing. Everything is dirtied up, basically chipped up, and we are ready now to start weathering our aircraft. How do you do that? It's actually not hard at all. First off, I use soft pastel chum, and it's a chalk. Now, this is available from Walmart, and that's where I got these. I think it was like $5. I'm sure Office Depot, Staples, Michaels, Hobby Lobby, any of those craft, big generic-type department stores will have this. And you open it up, and we're going to use a few colors here. And so I've got a few Dixie cups. And we're going to use brown, black, and this tan. And, well, there you go. Look at that. That is how you make a mess, everybody. So here's this tan, really light, like a mustard yellow. Now, what you want is you want to turn it into a chalk like I've got it inside the can there, or inside the little cup. The best way I've found, and quick and easy, is rotary grind coarse thing from Robart. I don't know exactly, it's kind of like a cone shape. I turn the Dremel on slow, and I make sure, as you can see, it's rotating this way. So I'm going to sit down, I'm going to hold it here to where it shoots all this stuff down into the cup. I'm going to come back and use my brown. And then black. And so now we have our three colors. We have a mustard yellow, a brown, and a black. And to give you an idea, fuel stains on an aircraft routinely turn to a yellowish gold color. Brown emulates dirt and grime, and of course the black grease. The grease that's used on most aircraft is a specific moly-based grease that is just coal black and does nothing but make a mess and keep things well lubricated. Next, how are we going to apply those? Well, a couple packages of paint brushes from Walmart, and different types. You're going to need multiple brushes, and you will find as you do this certain brushes for certain applications. This one here, kind of poofy, kind of like a lady's makeup brush, and it's just for very light dusting and such. I have this big, rather stiff bristled chalk brush, and that's to do the entire airplane and just kind of streak it. I have one here that's got some very soft hairs, but they've been like a camel hair brush, but it's been clipped and at an angle, or kind of a very thin angle, to allow me to streak. We have those here, a couple of round ones, very similar. And you'll just use pretty much all of these. And you can get, you know, these packages of paintbrushes are about $5 a piece. They're not very expensive. You get them, and then they just kind of reside in your scale stuff little bucket of tools that you will use on airplanes. Another one, you remember our pilot we put in the airplane? Well, actually, he's barefoot because we needed his boots. And here are his boots. And what we're looking for is the boot prints. As maintainers would walk across the wing to load the guns and such, we're going to have a couple of boot prints on the wing. All that because, believe me, if they're tromping around in the mud and the dirt and getting up on the airplane, when they're done, they're getting ready to send an aircraft out on a mission, or they got to load 12 or 20 aircraft. They don't have time to come back and wash everything off. They try and keep stuff as clean as it can be to a point. There aren't chunks of dirt, but there are going to be remnants of them walking on the airplane. And last but not least, steel wool. And we are going to use steel wool to help burnish and rub everything in. And this is a 4-aught. It's 0000 is the number of the steel wool. It's the finest grade. You can find this at Home Depot, Lowe's, Walmart, any main hardware store in the paint area. You get a whole bag of it, and I'm still on a bag that I bought 5 or 6 years ago. The steel wool lasts for a very long time. So that's basically what we're going to need to have to weather. So let's go ahead, and we're going to throw some gun streaks and on the wing and show you how we do it. So here we're starting on the bottom of the wing. You notice I have a paper towel up here on the wing. And I have my one little camel hair brush that I have gone ahead and trimmed. And the key here is try not to get too much, make a couple of passes. Of course, we're following the airflow. I'm working this just ever so slowly. It'll take you a while to weather an airplane, a good couple of hours. And don't think because there's a black stripe where this gun is that we shouldn't weather it. It will change the shade. Go ahead and weather it as well. Now I'm going to come back with my steel wool. I'm just going to lightly wipe. I'm going to come in with a little bit of brown now. And back with a black. And then our steel wool. And here, you can kind of see the weather pattern of the guns. Okay, next is our wheel well. And our compressibility flap would have seen a lot of use and would have probably been greased up pretty heavy. So I'm starting right on the panel line for the compressibility flap. And I am going to try a different brush, one that's just a little stiffer. I'm going to come back with my bigger brush and just streaking it ever so much. I'm going to hit the back side of my wheel wells. And most definitely the hinge areas. And follow with some steel wool, just lightly wiping. The effects are subtle, is what you're looking for. You're not looking for anything crazy and big. Now, I'm going to sit down, I'm going to go to my brown. And I'm kind of just dusting some chalk over the leading edge of the airplane. Very little on the outside, a little bit more on the inside. I'm going to go ahead and notice I'm wiping. What this will do is this will kind of highlight the rivet areas. And another spot we want to throw a lot of dirt up is figure if the gear was down and they're operating off an unapproved runway, where would the tire be? Basically right here. And where would it sling stuff up on the airplane? Now we're going to just a tinge of black. And now we'll come back over it with some steel wool. And I'm going to come back. I'm not liking my gun ports, my exhaust. I want them a little bit darker. There we go. And there you can see the effect of the bottom of the airplane kind of dirtied up. And all we'll come back now and hit it with a light coat of clear to seal it. And that's basically how we do it. Okay, so we have gone ahead and weathered up the top of the airplane, or the top of the wing, the right wing. And as you can see, we're pretty much done. Interesting note, what you can do to also help build the illusion and the effect, as I hide behind the wing here, is what you may call cross-hatching and such. As you can see, there's certain panels here, and for example, this one, I'm actually going to rub in line, which would have been made sure the grain was in a certain position for maximum strength and such. And of course, after I've done the entire wing leading to trailing edge, come back and just hit a couple of panels, and you will find that will help in the light, give a different refractional light, and it'll almost appear as a different silver panel on the aircraft when it's all done. And really pretty cool. And as you can see, our plastic covered film ARF is tending to look a whole lot more like an expertly constructed model that you definitely would be proud to have at any flying field. So once you've got this done, the next thing is to come back with our flat clear. And we missed on coats at about 12 to 14 inches away. And I have a heat gun with me at the same time. I missed on the coat and I'm hitting it with a heat gun to dry it quickly. Two or three light misted coats each side. The panel's done. It's ready to put on the airplane and go fly. What we're going to do is we're going to move into the fuselage now. I'm going to show you some exhaust streaks and such and start to weather the fuselage. It's all done the same way. The big key, less is always more. Some of this effect will go away with the clear. And it just to deliver a slight illusion that the aircraft has been seeing some combat duty and some real action. Next of any warbird is the exhaust streaks. Engines running a lot, high power, superchargers, a lot of flying time. Exhaust is going to get a little gross. And then on this aircraft, there's two exhaust ports, one here and one on the exact same place on the opposite side. And then we have the turbo supercharger port at the back right in front of the tail wheel. There'd be light exhaust residue back there as well when he's at high altitude. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you with some blacks and some browns and some yellows to try to bring the streaks to life. Now you will note I have added a small piece of plastic to emulate a big sheet of steel that would have been here for where the exhaust pipe came out to protect the fuselage. I've added that and glued it on, and I have also a half inch diameter piece of plastic tube. Just a little stack, drilled a hole and glued it in place. The inside of the stack is painted with flat black from testers, model masters, and then you'll see little specks of brown, and that's the rust, because this would have been a steel exhaust stack. And it's definitely going to rust sitting out there in the weather. I'm going to come in with my chalk and I'm going to dirty up the sides of the pipe is all I'm looking to do right now. So now I'm going to take my big brush. Brown. I want to make sure that mixture is running plenty lean and giving optimum performance, so you don't want it to be all black and sooty. And then I'm even going to touch it with some yellow. And you can see I'm getting kind of heavy. Probably going, my goodness, he said less is more, and look at what he's doing. Steel wool straight through there. Got a little different brush, kind of a fan. Lightly rub the wool through it. You can see some of the rivets pop and such. So now we're going to kind of start to just grubby up and dirty up the fuselage a little bit. I'm going to sprinkle some of that magic dust on it here, and get a little bit of the brown going. And I'm even going to drop a slight bit of yellow. Now, follow up with my steel wool. Okay, we've been weathering and dirtying everything up. Pretty much have the whole airplane done now. And you'll see some more pictures of that as we're talking to you here. What's really cool is, as I said, this panel up here on the wing was designed, that's where all the ammo belts. So the guys had to get up on the wing and go and load these before every flight. Well, we have some boots from a 1/6 scale pilot. It's a 1/6 scale airplane. So I'm going to take some of my chalks, I'm going to put them here on a paper towel. Some black and some brown. And the key is we probably don't want to step on the flap. The flaps would have been down and such. And we have a right boot and a left boot. And the key here is to get us some prints. Going out to the wing and coming back. Let me get them going right, or you guys will give me a hard time. Although this looks a little crazy. And so now you can see our boot prints on top of that wing. Okay, we've kind of walked you through weathering and dirtying up your P-47, giving it that worn battlefield look, chipping some paint, gun streaks, exhaust streaks and such to definitely bring it to life. And you can see it. We've just kind of stuck it together here for the closing of this video. I still need to put the clear coat on. I'll do that. And like I said, we're going to mist on, hit it with a heat gun on low, and just get it dry real quick and a couple light misted coats. And she's done and ready to go. At that point, I am ready to head to the flying field. So, as we've been saying in the past, we'll see you in the shop next time. That's not the case here. We're pretty much closing down the build on the Hangar 9 P-47D-40 30cc Thunderbolt. Really cool airplane. Wicked Wabbit was our choice, as you can see. And all I can tell you is, our next time we see you on camera, we will be at the flying field putting the maiden on this baby, showing you what a P-47 can look like in the air. We hope you have enjoyed the series of build tutorials on how to put this airplane together, weathering it and bringing it to life. Remember, if you have any questions, you can always find me at editors@horizonrc.com. We'll see you at the flying field.